I am in charge of making payments to vendors. Recently, my CEO has been telling me not to make certain payments, even though he agreed to a payment plan. I've been getting calls from vendors who are not getting paid. I feel like I'm caught in the middle. How should I handle these calls? I got that. Oh, and I see that Jennifer sent in a follow-up note. Excellent, you have all the information, including invoices. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, good. I feel like I'm caught in the middle. How should I handle these calls? It sounds to me like there's a really strong segregation of duties, which is a great thing to have in your organization. So you're in charge of payments, but you don't authorize them. It's the CEO who has the authorization function. So in this case, what I would do, I would take this call with a three-pronged approach. First of all, listen to what the vendors have to say. It may seem like a waste of time because, you know, you could theoretically just cut them off and say, it's not me, call the CEO. I get that. However, this is also about vendor relations. If there's an equivalent to customer service, vendor service, right? You need great relationships with your company's vendors and other suppliers. So give them a chance to discharge their own emotions, because if they get cut off, there's going to be an upset created. So just give them a chance, give them a listening. You don't have to ask probing questions. That's not what this call is about, but give them a listening. If you're so moved, you can even do a little active listening and reflect back a summary of what they just said. What I hear you saying is X. Is that right? Okay, got it. Now, why is this worth it? Not only to avoid upset, but at this point, you can handle the second half of the call with amazing efficiency. And you share two things. So I shared with you a three-pronged approach. First is listening. Second, inform them of what you're committed to and what you can't do, and then let them know what their course of action is and give them support in doing that. So what you're committed to, you are committed to making all authorized payments correctly and when authorized. That's what your commitment is. What you can't do is authorize a payment. So that's the second prong. Then finally, you share that your CEO is the only one who is authorized, or you know, who provides authorization for you making the payments. So your meaning the vendors, your time, I don't want you to waste any more time with me because unfortunately I'm not allowed to say yes, but here's the CEO's phone number, here's his direct line, or here's her direct line. Give her a call, give him a call, and see what the two of you can create together. And whatever my CEO authorizes, I will absolutely execute on time and with the correct dollar amount. And at that point in the conversation, you can close out the call efficiently, and it can be up to the vendor to contact the CEO. By the way, as an addendum, once your CEO comes to a resolution with an outside vendor, I would have the CEO document in writing what was agreed upon, send out an email. It was great to catch up. I apologize because of the payments, and this is what you and I disagreed upon. If you agree with the summary of what we disagreed upon, please reply and let me know, and then you can keep that for the record. If you're not in charge of bookkeeping, if you're in charge of making payments, you can the CEO can pass that directly to the bookkeeper and have that note be attached to the vendor file. Thank you so much for writing in. I know that this can be very uncomfortable, and I hope that this three-step process of listening, sharing what you're committed to and what you can't do, and then providing them support in going to someone who is authorized to say yes. I hope that's helpful to you and makes it comfortable and fluid and not uncomfortable at all. One of my grandfathers always said, never accept no from a person not in a position to say yes. Is that great? In this case, you're not in a position to say yes, so you can help someone get to that position. I'm going to say that again. That's just great wisdom, isn't it? Never accept no from a person not in a position to say yes.